The name of this next activity is called spool winding. S-P-O-O-L, spool winding. Nurses, you really get a feel for the stiffness in this man's hand, and you can see how his index finger looks like a contracture where the muscles are getting shortened and is pulling his index finger way over to the side. The three materials with the spool winding are simply a paper towel tube, a length of yarn, oh, let's say 7 to 15 inches long, and a styrofoam spool. And with the spool winding, you do exactly what it sounds like you would do. You wind and unwind the yarn. This is a two-handed activity. Look at the nice movement, nurses, I'm getting in my fingers. Or it can be a one-handed activity. You can start someone out and have a goal to wind and unwind a 7-inch piece of yarn. Revised goal in 6 months to wind and unwind a 10-inch, 12-inch piece of yarn. You might have a goal to maybe do this with total physical assistance or verbal request. Then you take this and put this in a paper bag, tape it to the nightstand, and say, Joe is exercising his fingers by winding and unwinding the yarn. I like the styrofoam spool the best because it's lighter weight than a wooden spool, and if somebody gets whirling this around inappropriately, that's true, that's true. Nothing's real anymore, is it? She said you can't find wooden spools anymore. With the styrofoam spool, it's large enough that someone cannot eat it, put it in their mouth. Someone said, what about like a metal nut, like a nut and a bolt? And these are left in the patient's room, so I would be very leery to leave that sort of item in a patient's room. Any questions about the spool winding? Yes. Do I have? She said it's so.
Yes, you have to.
And this is on videotape. She says, "Really, this is a paper towel tube to do." It's like tube to do. Terrific. The next time this woman over here raises up her hand, I'm not calling on her. I'm going to ignore her. Now I'm wondering, between now and the end of the workshop, what else is she going to have me do? Golly, this is a fun group. Sorry. Oh, yes. Okay, you saw this one the other day, and this is shape sorting, S-H-A-P-E, shape sorting, and you already have that one written down from before. You take a shoebox, blocks, baby food jar lids or Gatorade lids, and a rectangle of cardboard, and it's based on the Tupperware shape ball. This is a 100-year-old woman, has no teeth in her mouth, not a diabetic, and obviously needs to gain weight. An example of interdisciplinary care planning between activities and dietary. We had for her to put the shapes in the box, and her reward was to give her candy. She had a big bag of those circus peanuts, those orangey gum candies, and it was really cute. The activity director would come past and put one of the gum candies in her mouth, and she would gum it to death.
Gum candy,
right. You can see her very rigid shoulder that she has here that she's having to lift up like this, but nursing wanted her to be moving her arms as much as possible, so this also coordinated with the nursing goal. She was a bedridden resident. Whoops. This slide has slid. This is a paper bag taped to the nightstand. Shoebox with the shape sorting in it. show somebody doing that in their lap.